A few weeks ago, I reviewed this head strap for the Quest 2 and Quest 3 from BinBok VR, and overall, I really, really like it. It's comfortable to wear, the build quality is good, and the hot swappable batteries are freaking awesome. But my number one complaint about it, and the number one complaint I've seen from other reviewers here on YouTube, is how the head strap has a tendency to not lock in place where you set it. In my review video, which you can check out by clicking on the banner popping up in the upper right of your screen right now, I talk about how I own three of these head straps, one for my Quest 3 and one for each of my Quest 2s. When using the adjustment wheel on each of these straps, I found they all behaved differently. The very first one I bought tightens up just fine and stays where you set it while it's on your head, but after you loosen it, it has a tendency to tighten down on its own, which is super annoying when you're trying to put the headset on. The second one I bought for my Quest 3 works perfectly. It stays where I set it when I tighten it down, and it also stays where I set it after loosening it. When I purchased my third head strap, I hoped it would function just like the strap for my Quest 3 did, but it ended up not locking in place at all. You could simply push and pull on the strap to tighten and loosen it, which I was pretty sure it wasn't supposed to do. It worked okay, but anytime you adjusted the headset on your face, it would loosen, which became more and more annoying to me each time I used it. By the time I thought about returning the strap to get a new one, I was already outside the return window, so the only thing I could really do was see if I could find a way to fix it. To do that, I first needed to learn how the gears on these head straps work, and then find out what was causing them all to operate differently. I wasn't sure if they were all using different mechanisms, or if it was just poor quality control on the part of BinBok VR. And spoiler alert, it was the quality control. After disassembling the straps to look at them, I found they all use the exact same gear mechanism. However, there was some very slight variation in the main gear piece that performs the locking function. My assumption is, since this part is made of plastic, after it's molded, it sometimes deforms a little bit as the plastic cools. But anyway, as you can see here, the way it's supposed to work is the little teeth on the end of these spiral arm things lock into the teeth on this outer ring. As you turn the wheel to the right, because of the shape of the spiral arms, it allows the teeth to click in and out as you turn it around. And when you stop at a certain position, again, because the arms are shaped to only allow them to move in one direction, it stays locked in place. To get the head strap to loosen, there are some little tabs here on the back of the adjustment wheel that push against the arms to disengage the teeth and allow the strap to loosen. A pretty simple and ingenious design, really. Well, the problem with my third head strap was these little spiral arms drooped down where the teeth never interlocked with the teeth in the outer circle. As you can see here, the gear just spins and spins, and the teeth do not lock in place like they're supposed to. My first thought was maybe I could wedge something between the arms and the center hub here to push the arms out where the teeth would then lock in place as they're intended to. I tried using some small pieces of 3D printer filament for this, but as you'd turn the gear, they would fall out of place. So that wasn't really effective at all. Maybe I could have glued them in place, but I decided rather than mess with wedging the arms out and possibly creating some other problem, I would try to actually fix them. My next idea was to try to use a hairdryer to heat the plastic up and bend the arms out where they should be. My only reservation to doing that, though, was what if I completely screw this thing up? What if I break one or all of the arms off and then the head strap becomes completely unusable? This then led me to my third idea, and the one I ended up going with, and that was to model the gear in AutoCAD and 3D print an entirely new gear. With that decision made, I pulled out my calipers and started measuring things out, and after a few hours of work, I had a model that looked pretty darn good. I queued it up on my Bamboo Lab P1S printer, and a short 20 minutes later, I did my first test fit. Now, anyone who has done something like this before knows it would take a miracle for a part like this to work perfectly on the first try. And as expected, things did not quite fit right. I then went back to AutoCAD to make some adjustments and printed up the gear again. This time it fit a little better, but still needed some more adjustment. So I went back to AutoCAD a third time, tweaked things a little bit more, and somewhat to my surprise, the third time was the charm, and the part fit and operated perfectly. Now, if you have one of these BinBok straps, and yours locks in place just fine, but cinches down on its own all the time, you do not need to replace this gear. All you need to do is snug up a little screw that holds the adjustment wheel in place. There is a little bit of disassembly required to get to it though, so let's show you how to do that. The first thing you need is a thin plastic tool, like a guitar pick or something. And you need to run it along this seam between the white and black plastic here and separate them from each other. I've found it works best if you start at the opening where the side straps come into the back housing and then just work your way toward the center. You'll then go over to the other side and do the same thing. With that done, we now need to flip the strap over and do this again on the other side. Once you've popped it loose all the way around, the head brace side of the cover will come off, and this screw right here in the middle is the only one that we need to worry about. If your head strap is constantly cinching down on its own, all you need to do is snug this screw up a little bit with a small Phillips head screwdriver. It is a metal screw threading into plastic, so you don't want to over tighten it. Just snug it up little by little until the strap no longer cinches down on itself anymore. If your head strap doesn't lock in place at all like this one, we'll need to remove this screw, which will allow us to take off the wheel cover here and get to our gear to repair or replace it. For anyone who wants to 3D print a new gear like I did and replace the stock gear, I've placed a link to printables.com in the video description where you can download the STL file and print off your own replacement part. For those of you who don't have access to a 3D printer, then I hope you've got more guts than I do, because unless you have a better idea than I've been able to come up with, you're going to have to try heating the little arms up with a hairdryer or a heat gun and then bending them out to the correct place. Once you've swapped in your new or repaired gear, you can place the wheel cover back on and secure it in place again with its screw. You can then replace the head brace section of the strap by first making sure you orient it correctly. BinBok has stamped some arrows on both parts to help you know the proper way to orient them, and then it's just a matter of snapping the cover back into place. And once that's done, you're ready to put the strap back on your headset and enjoy your now properly working head strap! I know this video is super niche, and that there may be very few people this video will even be of use to. For those few of you, though, that this video helped, I'm happy you were able to find it and use the information in it to get your head strap working properly. And for those of you who don't own one of these head straps and watch the video anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you found the video informative and in some way, maybe even a little bit entertaining. I made this video because I love learning how things work, as well as fixing things and creating things, and this little project just ticked all the boxes for me, and I really wanted to share it. Anyway, thanks for learning with me today, and I hope to catch you in the next one. Come on, do it, you know you want to. Subscribe!